Hey, what's up, y'all? I'm BrambleGaming, and by now I'm pretty sure that almost everyone that has played a Mario game knows of the Toad characters. But, for those of you who are uncultured, Toads are side NPCs in the Mario series that usually only exist to help the player, but are also playable in rare cases. These characters have made a reputation as a meme on the internet, mainly for their famous dialogue and excruciatingly annoying voice.
I'm the best!
Toads can come in all sorts of different types, such as Red Toad, Blue Toad, Green Toad, Yellow Toad, Purple Toad, Female Toad, Grandpa Toad, Paper Toad, Mummy Toad, Driver Toad, and Mario Toad. Wait, what? However, there has been a specific Toad character that got enough popularity to where he even starred in a standalone game. His name? Why, Captain Toad, of course. This character is first introduced in 2007 in Super Mario Galaxy for the Nintendo Wii, in which he played a role as the captain who went on expeditions with his crew to try and help Mario find Power Stars. Eventually, Captain Toad got his own standalone game, Captain Toad Treasure Tracker, in 2014, which is also coming to the Nintendo Switch and 3DS this year. In Captain Toad Treasure Tracker, your main goal is to solve simple puzzles to get Power Stars and gems. But here's the catch, there is no input to make Captain Toad jump in this game. Now, Nintendo explains in the game guide of Captain Toad Treasure Tracker that Captain Toad cannot jump because of the weight in his backpack that he carries. However, Captain Toad can jump. Nintendo was straight up lying, and I have proof. In the final cutscene of Captain Toad Treasure Tracker, Captain Toad crawls out of a minecart to chase down a green power star, leading into a tie-in with Super Mario 3D World. But watch what happens in this particular portion of the cutscene. Did you catch it? Here, I'll play it again. See it this time? Captain Toad obviously jumps. He doesn't use his arms to climb up into the pipe, no, he straight up jumps into the air. So, if he cannot jump, according to Nintendo, why did they put this cutscene showing him jumping in the game? Well, to be honest, I'm not sure. They might have just slid it in there hoping no one would notice, but we did, Nintendo, we did notice. And now we know never to trust your stupid lore again. We could have been jumping with Toad this whole time, which would have been extremely useful with defeating enemies such as Bitty Buddies, Piranha Plants, and basically every single other enemy in this stupid game! But, in conclusion, Nintendo claims Captain Toad cannot jump. However, there is a cutscene in the game that clearly shows Captain Toad jumping, therefore proving that he does have the ability to jump. And therefore, Nintendo did a very bad dumb. Roll the end card screen!